morning everybody. Today we are going to discuss the overall profitability ratio. Okay, so we know that profit is the most important part of a concern. If a particular firm is earning more and more profit, then we can say that the particular firm is efficient. Okay, so looking at the profit only, can we declare that a particular firm is efficient or not? That is the question. So apart from profit, what you can say, the another thing which we can say is capital employed is also required to measure the efficiency of a concern. Suppose firm A is there, but if that firm A is there and firm B is there, okay, and firm E is and A is earning how much the profit? Let they take the profit is how much for firm A? 40,000. For firm B, let take the profit is how much? 50,000. Okay, but if you can compare in between firm A and firm B, we can declare that the firm B is superior or efficient as compared to firm A. Because in terms of profit, that shows the efficiency of the organization, firm B is better than firm A. But if you are ignoring how much capital invested, if you are ignoring how much the capital investment, then the conclusion what you are drawing is not correct. So let's take the capital employed by the firm A is 2 lakh and firm B is how much? 5 lakh. Look at it. Out of the capital investment 2 lakh, the firm is A is earning profit of 40,000 and firm B is investing 5 lakh and the profit is how much? 50,000. That means it is 10% profit is earning by firm B. And if you can see how much the profit, okay, so if you can see more than, it is something like 20% is the profit is earned by firm A. So what is that? You have to compare the capital investment to the profit. Capital investment, or it is known as what? Capital employed. Okay, so how much you are employed, the capital is important. Okay, based upon your capital investment or capital employed, you have to compare the firm. Then you can declare that which firm is efficient. Here, if you see firm B is superior than firm A, because firm B is earning what and firm A is earning what. If you are ignoring the capital investment, then firm B is superior. If you are considering the capital investment, then firm A is superior, because the firm A is earning 20% of its profit from its capital employed, whereas firm B is earning only the 10% of profit from its capital employed. So you have to compare in between the two firms based upon the capital investment only. You can decide how much it is the proportion of the profit it is earned to the particular capital. Okay, you have to calculate the profit to the capital ratio. Okay, if the profit to capital ratio is higher, then we can say that the particular firm is here. You can say, look at this is 40,000 by 2 lakh. So it is around how much? 20%. This is how much? 50,000 by 5 lakh. So how much? It is around 10%. So 10% here, 20%. So which firm is better? Firm A is better than firm B. Simply looking at the profit, you can't say, you can't declare, you can't interpret, you can't make conclusion that a particular firm is better than to that competitor. You have to compare its capital investment to the profitability, then only you can say that whether the firm is good or bad or efficient or not efficient. Okay, so we have to calculate different kind of profitability ratio, overall profitability ratio. Okay, so last class we discussed about the profitability ratio. Now we are discussing about the overall profitability ratio. So what are the overall profitability ratio? The first is coming, which is under the overall profit ratio, return on shareholders fund. Okay, return on shareholders investment. Shareholders investment. Return on shareholders investment. So it is otherwise known as what? ROI. Return on shareholder investment or net worth. We can tell that it is a net worth. So how to calculate the return on shareholders investment? It can be calculated. The ROI can be calculated. Net profit after tax. Net profit after tax divided by shareholders fund. Okay. Shareholders fund. So net profit after tax divided by shareholder fund, then what you will get? Return on shareholders fund or return on investment. Return on investment, okay, that is ROI, can be calculated net profit after tax by shareholder fund. If the ratio is higher, then we can say better is the efficiency of the organization. It shows that long term the particular company is having the efficiency. So this ratio should be higher and higher, and net profit should be calculated after deducting the tax only. And the shareholder fund, we know what should be included under the shareholder fund: equity share capital, preference share capital, reserve, that is capital reserve or revenue reserve, and whatever the accumulated losses will be there, that we have to deduct. Then only we can get what? Shareholder fund. And not net profit should be calculated after deducting what? Tax. That is known as what? Return on investment, or return on what? Shareholders investment. This is the most important ratio. So higher is the ratio, better is the efficiency of a particular concern, or better is the profitability of the particular concern, we can say. Okay, so we have to go for a problem. Let's write, what is the question? Issued and subscribed capital. Okay, what is the issued capital and subscribed capital? How much the capital is issued and how much the capital is subscribed? Okay, so under this head, 2000 equity shares of rupees 100 each. 2000 equity shares of rupees 100 each. So what is that? 2 lakh. Okay, then 1000 8% preference share. Preference share of rupees 100 each, then 1 lakh. Okay, equity share capital kitna diya hai? 2 lakh. And preference share capital kitna diya hai? 1 lakh. So total how much? 3 lakh. Then reserve and surplus. Reserve and surplus. So under this category, what are the things are there? Okay, let's take revenue reserve. Revenue reserve, it is given. How much it is given? Revenue reserve 30,000. Then capital reserve, it is given. Capital reserve, it is given. That is given 50,000. Then reserve and contingency. Reserve for contingency, for contingencies. That is how much given? 20,000. So 50 plus 30 plus 20, that is how much? Outer column, that is 1 lakh. Okay. Then net profit before interest and tax. Net profit before interest and tax. Net profit before interest and tax, that is given 1,50,000. Then interest charges. Interest charges. So how much the interest charges? That is given 30,000. Thereafter tax rate. Tax rate, that is given 50%. Okay, so what you have to calculate? Calculate return on shareholders investment. Return on shareholders investment. So this is the ratio we have to calculate. Return on shareholders investment, that is ROI. We have to calculate. Okay, this is a question. So how to give answer? So return on shareholders investment, that is commonly we can describe as ROI. Okay, so ROI can be calculated net profit after tax divided by shareholders fund. So yahan pe what is the main important thing? Net profit after tax. लुक एट एवरीबडी, यहाँ पे एक नेट प्रॉफिट दिया है जो कि बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स दिया है. हमें क्या कैलकुलेट करना है? नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स कैलकुलेट करना है. सो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स? वी कैन कैलकुलेट दिस नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर टैक्स. हाउ टू कैलकुलेट? लुक एट व्हाट इज द नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स, दैट इज 1,50,000. ओके, नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स, दिस इज नेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स. यू हैव टू डिडक्ट व्हाट? You have to deduct interest. So how much the interest you deducted? That is 30,000. Then how much the net profit before tax but after interest. This is before tax and after interest. So what could be the tax rate? It is given 50%. The tax rate is given 50%. So 120,000, so 50% is how much? 60,000. So 120,000 minus 60,000, then how much? 60,000. This 60,000 is nothing but this is net profit after tax and interest. Okay. So this is net profit after tax. The formula is net profit after tax and interest. Okay. Net profit after tax means net profit after tax and interest. So you have to deduct the interest, that is 30,000, and also you have to deduct the tax so that you can get a figure of how much. 60,000 is your, what is that? Net profit after tax. What is shareholder fund? Shareholder fund ka matlab kya hai? It is equity share capital, preference share capital, and whatever the reserves are there. So this is 2 plus 1, 3, and this is 30, 50, 20. So 30, 50, 20, that is how much? 1 lakh. So 3 lakh plus 1 lakh is how much? Shareholder fund is how much? 4 lakh. So 3 plus 1, that is 4 lakh. Okay. So 60,000 by 4 lakh. Always we have to mention it in terms of what? Percentage. So you are getting how much? 0.15. So it is how much? 15%. Okay. So this is the return on investment, which is we can calculate a net profit after tax. After tax, tax ka matlab kya hai yahan pe? After interest and tax. Okay. Not simply after tax, net profit after interest and tax divided by shareholders fund. Okay. In that way, you have to calculate net profit after interest and tax. Okay, we have to deduct the interest, we have to deduct the tax. Whatever the figure comes, we have to put in the numerator, and denominator is all about shareholder fund. Shareholder fund ka matlab kya hai? Equity share capital, preference share capital, and whatever the capital reserve and revenue reserve, and if contingency is there, you have to add. So in this particular company, always remember ROI should be multiplied by what? 100. Okay. So if you are multiply the by 100, then ultimately how much you are getting? You are getting a figure of how much? 15% in this particular question. So if you are interpreting the ROI, return on shareholders fund, or return on investment on shareholder fund, then always if ROI is higher, then that could be the better. If A particular firm is there and B is another firm is there. If A firm is there and B firm is there. If you are comparing A firm and B firm, if you are comparing inter-firm comparison, then the company who are having the higher ROI, that should be the better. That shows that the return from the shareholders' investment from the profit could be the higher. Next, we have to go for another. So always remember the ROI can be calculated net profit after interest and tax divided by shareholders fund. In this way you can calculate the ROI. Okay, higher is the ROI, better is the position, better is the investment for a particular company, we can say. Next one is return on equity capital, the second ratio which we can calculate under the head of overall profit. Return on equity capital, return on equity capital. So this is return on equity capital that can be calculated, that is net profit after tax, net profit after tax minus preference dividend divided by equity share capital, equity share capital, that is paid up equity share capital. Okay, so what is this ROC, that is return on equity capital? Always remember it is the fixed obligation of a firm to pay the preference dividend to the preference shareholder. So prior to, whenever a company gets profit, after paying the interest to the debenture holder, it is the duty of the firm to pay the dividend to the preference shareholder. A fixed amount of preference dividend is paid to the preference shareholder. After that, to whom it will be provided the dividend? It is to the equity shareholder. So it is deducted. So preference dividend should be deducted. Okay. So it is the when a firm is get liquidated and when a firm is actually earning good amount of profit, it is the equity shareholder who are getting lot of benefit out of that. Okay. So it is very much important to calculate what this particular return on equity capital. Equity capital में कितना return आ रहा है. Okay. So इसलिए हम क्या calculate करते हैं, return on equity capital. Okay. So let's go for a question. So यहाँ पे क्या दिया है, 10,000 equity shares. मतलब कितना इक्विटी शेयर्स है कंपनी के पास, 10,000 इक्विटी शेयर्स है. ओके, ऑफ रुपीस 10 ईच, ऑफ रुपीस 10 ईच. ओके, 8 पेड इज हाउ मच, रुपीस 80,000. नेक्स्ट वन इज हाउ मच, 11%, 5,000 प्रिफरेंस शेयर्स of rupees 20 each is equal to 1 lakh. Equity shares, preference, thereafter profit before tax equal to 80,000. Then rate of tax that is given 50%. Then we have to calculate ROC, that is return on RO, return on equity capital. Okay, so we have to calculate return on equity capital. So how to calculate return on equity capital, that can be calculated. Okay, so we have to solve this problem. So return on equity capital, so the formula is, what is that formula? Net profit after interest and tax minus preference dividend divided by equity share capital, that is paid of equity share capital. Okay, in this way we have to calculate, that is net profit after interest and tax divided by equity share capital, equity share capital, that is paid up. Okay, paid up. यहाँ पे आपका नेट प्रॉफिट क्या, कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे, लुक एट हाउ मच द प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स. ओके, द प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स इज हाउ मच, 80,000. ओके, सो दिस इज पीबीटी, प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स, दैट इज हाउ मच, 80,000. ओके, देर आफ्टर इज देर एनी इंटरेस्ट वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड. ओके, देर इज नो सच डिबेंचर इज इशूड, सो दैट्स वाई देर इज नथिंग रिक्वायर्ड, दैट वी कैन एज्यूम दैट द इंटरेस्ट इज ऑलरेडी डिडक्टेड टू हैव 80,000. Then rate of tax is how much? 50%. The rate of tax is, 50%. So 80,000 50% is how much? 40,000. So what you got now? 40,000. What is this profit? 40,000. This is net profit after tax. Okay. So net profit after tax you got. Okay. That formula is net profit after interest and tax. Okay. Check it. Minus preference dividend, that you should not forget. Okay, minus preference dividend. Okay, net profit after interest and tax minus preference dividend divided by equity share capital. Okay, this is net profit after tax you calculated, that is 40,000. Then what is the preference dividend? Okay, so preference dividend is always calculated to the preference share capital. So yahan pe kitna diya hai, 11%, 5,000 preference shares of rupees 20 each. So 1 lakh 11%. So 1 lakh 11% is how much? 11,000. So 11% of 1 lakh. So 11% of 1 lakh is what? That is 11,000. What is this 11,000? That is preference dividend. What is this 11,000? Preference dividend. So net profit after tax, that is 40,000, and preference dividend is how much? 11,000. So 40 minus 11, that is 29,000 it will come, divided by equity share capital. How much the equity share capital given in the question? That is given 80,000. Okay. So equity share capital is how much given? 80,000. So net profit after interest and tax, that is 40,000. Minus preference dividend we calculated, that is 11,000, and how much the equity share capital, that is 80,000. Okay, so that is how much, 40 minus 11, that is 29,000 divided by how much, 80,000. Okay, so you will get 0.3625. So that is 36.25%. Always the return on equity capital is mentioned on what, everybody, percentage. You should not forget to multiply what everybody percentage. Okay. So we covered what is the return on shareholders investment, that is ROI, and return on equity capital, that we cover the second ratio. And the third ratio is all about, what is the third ratio? Third ratio will be earning per share. Okay, so what do you understand by earning per share? How much a shareholder will earn towards a profit? How much the shareholder will earn? Which shareholder? The equity shareholder. How much the equity shareholder will earn? Okay, per 1 rupee of profit is known as earning per share. How to calculate earning per share? Earning per share, how to calculate? Net profit after interest and tax minus preference dividend, minus preference dividend. Okay, net profit after interest and tax minus preference dividend divided by number of outstanding equity shares. Number of outstanding equity shares. In this way you can calculate what? This earning per share. Suppose, question, suppose the EBIT of a company is how much? Let's take the EBIT of a company is 1 lakh. Okay. And interest that is given, how much? 20,000. Okay. Then the tax rate, let's take, that is 50%. Then preferences, okay, let's take preference is 8%. Okay, that is 1 lakh. Thereafter, equity share capital, ₹2 lakh, which is comprising of 2000 equity shares. 2000 equity shares. Okay, so this is the question. Okay, so what you have to calculate? Earning per share. So calculate earning per share. So you have to calculate earning per share. So how to calculate earning per share? Earning per share कैसे calculate करना है? यहाँ पे क्या दिया है? EBIT दिया है. Earning before interest and tax is how much? 1 lakh दिया है. Okay, how much it is given? 1 lakh. Earning before interest and tax. उसके बाद, okay, so net profit after interest and tax we have to calculate. So this is earning before interest and tax, मतलब profit before interest and tax. Okay, less interest. Interest को deduct करो, interest deduct करो, interest कितना है? 20,000. Then how much it is came? 80,000. 80,000 is what? This is earning before tax. Okay, or profit before tax. Less tax. Tax कितना दिया है? 50% दिया है. तो कितना आएगा? 40,000. So you have to deduct. Okay, so 40,000 is what? That is earning after tax. Earning after tax or net profit interest and tax, that is same. Okay, so this is net profit after interest and tax. After interest and tax, that is how much? 40,000. Okay, so 40,000 came. Thereafter minus preference dividend. How much the preference dividend is there in the question? Okay, that is 8% of 1 lakh. Okay, that is the preference dividend. 1 lakh 8%. So how much? That is 8,000. Divided by number of outstanding equity shares. So how many equity shares are there in this particular question? 2000. So how much? 2000. It is the number, it is not the amount. So kitna company ke paas kitne equity shares hai, equity shareholders hai, that is 2000. So how to calculate on this regard? So 40,000 minus 8,000, that is 32,000. Okay, this is 40,000 minus 32,000. Divided by 2000. Okay, so 16 rupees per share. Okay, so what is the earning per share of the particular company? 16 rupees per share. If you compare a particular company who are having 16 per rupees per share and another company is the EPS is 20 rupees per share. Then which company is better? The company which is having the higher earning per share, that company is better. Okay, so how to calculate the earning per share? That is net profit, interest and tax. Net profit after interest and tax minus preference dividend divided by number of outstanding equity shares. नंबर ऑफ आउटस्टैंडिंग इक्विटी शेयर, यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन में कितना इक्विटी शेयर दिया था 2000. सो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स, दैट इज एंडिंग बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स माइनस व्हाट, एंडिंग बिफोर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स माइनस इंटरेस्ट, व्हाट केम दैट ईबीटी, दैट इज एंडिंग बिफोर टैक्स लेस टैक्स, दैट इज 50%, 80,000 50%, दैट इज 40,000. सो व्हाट यू गॉट एंडिंग आफ्टर टैक्स और नेट प्रॉफिट आफ्टर इंटरेस्ट एंड टैक्स, दैट इज 40,000. ओके, यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन में कितना प्रिफरेंस डिविडेंड होगा, यहाँ पे प्रिफरेंस डिविडेंड कितना है 8% प्रिफरेंस है. सो 1,08% इज हाउ मच 8,000. सो 40,000 माइनस 8,000 दैट इज 32,000. ओके, सो हाउ मेनी इक्विटी शेयर्स, हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स, दैट इज 2,000 इक्विटी शेयर. सो यू हैव टू डिवाइड इट बाय 2,000, देन व्हाट यू गॉट दैट इज नोन एज 16 रुपीज पर शेयर. व्हाट इज द 16 रुपीज पर शेयर, दैट इज अर्निंग पर शेयर. So now there is an important ratio. Okay, we have to see, that is return on capital employed. This is also important, everybody. So what is this return on capital employed? What is the profit the company is earning and how much the capital employed? That ratio is known as by return on capital employed. कंपनी कितना प्रॉफिट अर्न कर रहा है, कितना कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट किया है, कितना कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड किया है, उसे क्या बोलते हैं, रिटर्न ऑन कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड बोलते हैं. एंड दिस रेशियो इज हैविंग इट्स ओन इम्पोर्टेंस टू टेस्ट द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. दिस रेशियो इज क्वाइट वाइटल. इफ यू वांट टू कंपेयर योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विद अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, देन दिस रेशियो इज हेल्पफुल. इफ at what rate of interest you have to borrow the money as an interest, that depends upon your return on capital employed. You have to or you should bring the money or borrow the capital lesser than to this return on capital employed. It helps the firm for the inter-firm comparison, and there are other parties like different kind of the shareholders particularly. Okay, the shareholders are much more interested on this particular return on capital employed. Apart from shareholder, other creditors, bankers and financial institutions, they are also interested for this particular return on capital employed. Similarly also, whether a particular company is in a position to pay the different kind of factor prices, like whether you are having sufficient or enough efficiency in organization to pay the rent to the landlord, to pay the wages to your labor, to pay the interest to the capital, whether you are having that much of capacity to pay the factor price for your factor of production or not, that can be known through this particular return on capital employed only. So it is very important ratio. Okay, so it is very much important ratio for the shareholder point of view and other creditor point of view, and also for comparing your firm with other firm and to test the efficiency of your organization also. This is a particular ratio which is very much required, and very much it is a ratio that a particular company shareholders would see this particular ratio to test the efficiency of a particular organization, to check the efficiency of the organization. And this ratio can helpful to know or to conclude that whether the company's overall efficiency is good or not. So this is an important ratio, that is return on capital employed. Okay. So there is a question arises, what is capital employed? Okay, so what is capital employed? The capital employed can be calculated, okay, with this formula, that is share capital plus reserve and surplus, reserve
एंड सरप्लस सेम कैपिटल प्लस रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस प्लस नॉन करेंट लाइबिलिटी. व्हाट इज ए नॉन करेंट लाइबिलिटी? विच इज नॉट ए करेंट लाइबिलिटी मीन्स लॉन्ग टर्म लाइबिलिटी इज ए लॉन्ग टर्म लाइबिलिटी इज ए नॉन करेंट लाइबिलिटीज.
ओके. Similarly, there is another alternative formula is there for the capital employed. Okay,
that is net fixed asset. Net fixed asset
plus
non-current trade investment minus current liability. So this is the formula you have to use for the what?
Capital employed. Okay.
So return on capital employed.
How to calculate?
Return on capital employed.
That is net profit. You have to remember now, you should not go for after interest and tax.
Net profit before interest and tax. Divided by capital employed whole into 100.
This is the formula you have to apply for the calculation of what? Return on capital employed. Okay. So we have to go for solving a problem. Look at it. Capital employed can be calculated for this formula: share capital plus reserve and surplus plus non-current liability. Or alternatively, you can use this formula to calculate the capital employed, that is net fixed asset plus non-current trade investment minus current liability. So return on capital employed can be calculated, net profit before interest and tax. So whatever the formula we have calculated, they are all net profit after interest and tax. Now we have to use net profit before interest and tax divided by capital capital employed whole into 100. So we have to multiply with the 100 to check or to calculate this return on capital employed to know the overall efficiency of an organization. Okay.
So let's go for a question. So what is the share capital given? This question is share capital. So how much it is given? It is 1 lakh.
Okay, then reserve and surplus.
Reserve and surplus.
So how much given?
50,000.
Thereafter,
non-current liability. Non-current liability. That is 4 lakh.
Thereafter, net fixed asset.
Net fixed asset.
There is how much? 4,50,000. Then non-current
trade investment. Non-current trade investments. Not current trade investments. How much it is given?
That is 50,000.
Then current asset.
How much the current asset given?
2,20,000.
Thereafter,
current liability.
So what is the current liability?
That is 1,70,000.
So what you have to calculate?
Okay. So you have all information and net profit before tax. That is given how much? 1,20,000.
This is the information provided. Okay.
Then what we have to calculate? We have to calculate a return on capital employed.
Okay, so this is the question. We have to calculate the return on capital employed.
So how to calculate the return on capital employed? Okay, so return on capital employed can be calculated net profit before interest and tax. Okay, so net profit before tax, before any interest tax. So what is net profit before tax? That is given, that is how much? 1,20,000. So we have to deduct the interest, sorry, we have to add. So as net profit before tax and interest. So we have to add interest. How much the interest? Look at how to calculate the interest. So here how much? 120,000 is given. Okay, non-current liability on bracket is given 12% long-term borrowing. 12% long-term borrowings. Okay, it is given in the question. Long-term, that is non-current liability, that is 12% long-term borrowing. Long-term loan kitna hai? 12%. Kiska? Okay, so long-term loan is total amount 4 lakh. And what is the name of the long-term borrowing? That is 12%. So what could be the interest? That is 12% of 4 lakh. That is how much? That is 48,000. So interest will be 12% of how much? 4 lakh. So that is 48,000 is the interest. So this is net profit before interest and tax. Always we have to calculate on while calculating the return on capital employed, net profit before interest and tax. That is how much we have to add. Now we are adding, not deducting. If after tax we could have been calculated, or after interest we could have been deducted. Okay. So net profit before interest and tax, thereafter capital employed. Capital employed. How to calculate capital employed? Okay, the capital employed can be calculated. Share capital plus reserve and surplus plus non-current liability. Share capital plus reserve and surplus plus non-current liability. NCL means non-current liability. What is the share capital? Okay, how much the share capital we have to see? Okay, that is 1 lakh is your share capital. Equity share capital you have to take. Okay. Then how much the reserve and surplus? Just check, that is 50,000. How much is the non-current liability? That is a long-term liability. Okay, that we have to see how much. That is 4 lakh. So that is 5,50,000. 5,50,000 is your what? Capital employed. Okay, so capital employed is how much? 5,50,000. So the return on capital employed, okay, that can be calculated. Net profit before interest and tax divided by what? Capital employed. Capital employed. So net profit before interest tax 1,68,000. Okay, you should multiply with 100. Okay, divided by capital employed, we calculated 5,50,000 whole multiplied by 100. So ROCE can be calculated with net profit before interest and tax divided by capital employed into 100. Though, so how much you are getting? So 30.545%. 30.545%. This is a percentage you have to check. Okay, so you have to remember. So that should be net profit before interest and tax in the numerator, and the denominator capital employed will be there. And the capital employed will be calculated, share capital plus reserve and surplus plus non-current liability. Okay. This is the way you have to proceed. You can calculate this particular return on capital employed, which is very much important so far as this particular overall profitability is concerned, which shows that overall efficiency of a particular concern. So this is very much important for your examination point of view also. Okay.